point of SPOT is to be able to carry cameras and sensors and just as much as we can get into areas that we'd rather people not spend a lot of time. That can be areas that are radioactive, have contamination dust. We don't want people going there. Send your robot. Well, we would like to protect our robot. So particularly with dust and radioactive contamination dust, we don't want that getting into sensitive parts of the robot where we can't clean it out and it just becomes a mess. We ended up reaching out to COD because our group leader, Mei Ling, already had a working relationship with COD, had worked with the students, and we figured if we want to protect our robot with personal protective equipment, we should talk to experts in the field that know how to do this properly. And it's a lot of fun working with students. They bring a creativity and just an energy to jobs that make it just a joy to work with them.
Our protective equipment, we had like prototypes, and we were working off of basically like a box. But now that we have the actual robot here, it's really great to be able to see how we can put it on and how we can fit it and see where everything lands.
I never thought we would ever work on a robot. It's not what you come to fashion school for typically, but it's been an amazing experience.
So we just fit the backside. We're going to flip him over and attach it, and then hopefully we can see if it stays on him as he moves.
No, never thought Fashion Studies and Fermilab would be partners. It was such a unique opportunity, so we jumped on it, and I was so thankful that they reached out to us. You know, fashion design students don't always end up designing fashion. They design other things. And so this is a window into that, that knowledge of how to design and problem solve can be applied really to anything. And so we really do teach design. We apply it to fashion, but it really can be applied to anything. And now they have more opportunities, other things that they can look at and possibly design for.